Well, this is Fontana Lake, and Fontana Dam is coming up shortly, I think. It's quite an amazing spot, but look at this view. Let me turn the camera around. Beautiful day, too. I gotta climb up into those mountains today. Well, I'm at the dam. It's pretty impressive. I mean, very impressive. There's the lake there. And then the actual overflow are these tunnels, which I would love to hold my camera over there and show you, but like I said, my phone is my camera. I am not risking the loss of that. A little observation visitor center. That valley, the river, gorge. Wow. Wow, just surrounded by big mountains too. And this is the start of the Smoky Mountains. Sometimes nature just makes seats. Oh, that's just that is perfect. Oh man. We got a long ways to go, but trail's been great. It's all uphill, but it's pretty smooth. Not bad yet. Not bad. I'm going about 1,000 feet per mile. Something like that. That is not bad. But I think there's gonna be some difficult parts coming up, but I'm taking my time, and it's beautiful out. It's a Monday morning. Man, I can't think of anything better to do. So about probably 9 miles to go to the shelter, so I can't sit around too long. But this thing is so so comfortable. Thanks, nature. I mean, I slept pretty good, but it was so damn windy. The tent was just flopping and flapping. Well, and I got 17 miles to hike today. And it's pretty hard. The trail's really nice. It's not like going straight up the hill or anything. Well, it has. I guess it has a couple times, but I got a long ways to go. Alright, later. I can just see Fontana Lake down there. It's just barely visible. Think you're at the top, you know, you look So, I'm with Gandalf, and then behind her, Old Geezer. And we're trying to beat some bad weather coming through the Smokies. There's just really cold snow, rain. It's kind of a slow burn kind of situation. It's going to be rainy one day and cold, and then the next day, that night, it's going to be snow and even colder, super high winds. So everybody's trying to get off the trail right now. And so we're putting down a big miles to try to get to a gap where we can get a ride and get into Gatlinburg. And so we're gonna go stay at a shelter tonight. We're either gonna do 8 or 11 more miles, and but anyway, there's a situation brewing. I knew it would happen in the damn Smokies too. So we might hike through the night too. That's what a lot of people are doing. They're hiking basically all night to get out. But one of the main roads is closed for the season. So it opens Thursday, a couple days. So anyway, stupid Smokies. Well, we only have a few miles left to go, but freaking trail, man, it is straight up and straight down, straight up, straight down, like 400 feet straight up, 400 feet down. It's a nightmare, and we're just trying to do 18 miles today because of the weather. And I mean, it's, weather's gonna be bad, so we have to do it. Man, does it suck. Stupid Smokies. So we're going through basically Mirkwood right now. It's just been absolutely beautiful. But heading to Klingman's Dome right now. It's at 6,412 feet. But we're not gonna be able to see anything because it's rainy and foggy. It is getting a little lighter out, so there's a possibility we might see something. I'm with Old Geezer and Gandalf still. And just walking through this beautiful wood. And this is Klingman's Dome, highest part on the AT. Oh, I guess I'm gonna go up there. I gotta take my umbrella off. So let's go up Klingman's Dome. Oh, this is cool. I wasn't gonna go up here, but my companions don't know I'm coming up here, so I hope they wait up for me at some point. I wasn't gonna come up here because of the wind. Okay, I'm gonna pause a second. I'm sorry for the not so smooth video, but wow.
I'm halfway through. This is about the halfway through point of the Smokies. I'm so glad too. It's been really difficult. So yeah, Klingman's Dome. This is awesome. Wow. Damn, this is cool. Let's see. Get a little better shot. I mean, you can't see much, obviously. But it's really windy. I know the sound is going to be bad. Apologies. Yes. The other cool thing about Klingman's Dome is it is the 200 mile mark. 200 miles. You just have to embrace the suck, as they say. You just walk through it. It's mud, it's wet, and there's just no option. Sometimes you can walk on the edge, but you don't want to damage the trail further if you can help it. But I got about 6.5 miles to go, and then we're going to get a ride into Gatlinburg. Well, still trying to get to that Newfound Gap. And we just met some ridge runners. Oh, I wish I would have introduced them. And what the ridge runners do is they work for the ATC, Appalachian Trail Conservancy. And they come out and they just help us to be stewards of the land and give us some advice and also just make sure everybody's okay. Give us trail conditions, weather conditions, and they clean the privies, they clean up the garbage. They're cool. Really, really awesome. And so, just not them, but we got about 4 miles to go yet. This has been the last 2 days. It's been some of the hardest. Well, yesterday was probably the hardest day that I've had so far on the Appalachian Trail and the Smokies. And I absolutely hated that part of the Smokies because it's just ridiculous climbs all day, up and down. And no views or anything, and the woods look exactly the same. But today, I mean, these woods are just magical. Really, they are.
60 degrees outside.
Okay, so we made it off the mountain, and they're trying to get everybody off the mountain right now because it's going to get really bad, really cold, and it's hard to stay dry, so if you get a couple days of rain, a day and night of rain, and then it gets freezing, it's dangerous up there. We were so lucky to get down. We're freezing right now. We're soaked to the bone, but we got into this hostel. It is beautiful. We're waiting for the owners to come and kind of give us a tour and let us know what to do and what not to do, that sort of thing. But it's all on donation-based. All games and then resupply for food. And I guess all the donations go to that. And then look at these rooms. All kinds of, you know, stuff you need. This is amazing. It's beautiful. My socks are wet, so I'm staying on the tile floor right now. But, man. We're just outside of Gatlinburg, and I think we'll be able to take a trolley. That's Gandalf and I. So, I think we're going to take a trolley in town, get some food. We get our clothes washed and dried, so yeah, so freaking nice. fireplace. Wow. So we got lucky. Got a ride off the mountain with old geezer and his wife, Kathy. Super nice. Dropped us off here, and then they're going home for Easter. We just have to get a motel. We can't stay here tomorrow. They're going on vacation, so we need a hotel in town. So I gotta look into that right now. We're gonna have to take a two zeros because they're talking about closing the road. If it gets any ice at all, they close the road, so we can't get back to the trail. Definitely not tomorrow. And the day after, it looks a little sketchy too. But anyway, later.